Magandang araw mga kapamilya. Today is Wednesday within the octave of Easter. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. Come, you blessed of my Father, receive the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. Alleluia.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest.
And on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father. Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father, have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen.
And let us pray. O God, who gladden us year by year with the solemnity of the Lord's resurrection, graciously grant that by celebrating these present festivities, we may merit through them to reach eternal joys. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Peter and John were going up to the temple area for the 3 o'clock hour of prayer. And a man crippled from birth was carried and placed at the gate of the temple, called the Beautiful Gate, every day, to beg for alms from the people who entered the temple. When he saw Peter and John about to go into the temple, he asked for alms. But Peter looked intently at him, as did John, and said, "Look at us." He paid attention to them, expecting to receive something from them. Peter said, "I have neither silver nor gold, but what I do have, I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene, rise and walk." Then Peter took him by the right hand and raised him up, and immediately his feet and ankles grew strong. He leaped up, stood and walked around, and went into the temple with them, walking and jumping and praising God. When all the people saw him walking and praising God, they recognized him as the one who used to sit begging at the Beautiful Gate of the temple, and they were filled with amazement and astonishment at what had happened to him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord.
Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord.
Give thanks to the Lord, invoke his name, make known among the nations his deeds. Sing to him, sing his praise, proclaim all his wondrous deeds.
Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord.
Glory in his holy name. Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord. Look to the Lord in his strength. Seek to serve him constantly.
Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord.
You descendants of Abraham, his servants, son of Jacob, his chosen ones. He, the Lord, is our God. Throughout the earth, his judgments prevail.
Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord.
He remembers forever his covenant, which he made binding for 1,000 generations, which he entered into with Abraham and by his oath to Isaac.
Rejoice, O hearts that seek the Lord. Together let us recite the sequence.
Christians, to the Paschal victim, offer your thankful praises. A lamb the sheep redeems, Christ, who only is sinless, reconcile sinners to the Father. Death and life have contended in that combat stupendous. The Prince of Life who died reigns immortal. Speak, Mary, declaring what you saw wayfaring, the tomb of Christ who is living, the glory of Jesus' resurrection, bright angels attesting, the shroud and napkin resting. Yes, Christ, my hope is arisen. To Galilee he goes before you. Christ indeed from death is risen, our new life obtaining. Have mercy, Victor King, ever reigning. Amen. Alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia. This is the day the Lord has made. Let us be glad and rejoice in it. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
That very day, the first day of the week, two of Jesus' disciples were going to a village 7 miles from Jerusalem called Emmaus. And they were conversing about all the things that had occurred. And it happened that while they were conversing and debating, Jesus himself drew near and walked with them. But their eyes were prevented from recognizing him. He asked them, "What are you discussing as you walk along?" They stopped, looking downcast. One of them, named Cleophas, said to him in reply, "Are you the only visitor to Jerusalem who does not know of the things that have taken place there in these days?" And he replied to them, "What sort of things?" They said to him, "The things that happened to Jesus the Nazarene, who was a prophet mighty in deed and word before God and all the people, how our chief priests and rulers both handed him over to a sentence of death and crucified him. But you're hoping that he would be the one to redeem Israel. And besides all this, it is now the third day since this took place. Some women from our group, however, have astounded us. They were at the tomb early in the morning and did not find his body. They came back and reported that they had indeed seen a vision of angels who announced that he was alive. Then some of those with us went to the tomb and found things just as the women had described, but him they did not see. And he said to them, 'Oh, how foolish you are, how slow of heart to believe all that the prophets spoke. Was it not necessary that the Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory?' Then beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he interpreted to them what referred to him in all scriptures. As they approached the village to which they were going, he gave the impression that he was going on farther. But they urged him, 'Stay with us, for it is nearly evening, and the day is almost over.' So he went in to stay with them, and it happened that while he was with them at table, he took bread, said a blessing, broke it, and gave it to them. With that, their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, but he vanished from their sight. Then they said to each other, 'Were not our hearts burning within us while he spoke to us on the way and opened the scriptures to us?' So they set out at once and returned to Jerusalem, where they found gathered together the 11 and those with them who were saying, 'The Lord has truly been raised and has appeared to Simon.' Then the two recounted what had taken place on the way and how he was made known to them in the breaking of bread." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Now, this is one of the most beautiful resurrection appearances. This is among my top three favorite resurrection appearances. No, anyway, as we continue that dynamics of non-recognition and recognition, again, the first point that we will reflect on. No. We want to see it within the context now of this particular narrative, no? And then the second is that, again, the Lord now, second point, the Lord introduces something very important for our Christian formation and Christian journey, no? A journey as followers of Christ, as disciples of Christ, and that is the grace of remembering, no? Then the third and final point is that missionary impulse that comes with the recognition, no? And in this case, at the breaking of bread. So that's the third point for our reflection. First, about the non-recognition. Again, you realize, no, as you listen to the story closely, these two disciples were really mourning, no? And part of the mourning is what you mentioned yesterday already, that you know, imagine them dedicating their lives for 3 years, leaving behind everything, then not happening according to what they thought was going to happen, no? And he ended up dying on the cross. Total defeat and It's like dreams shattered, no? If you want to make it very, very vivid and dramatic, no? That was the feeling. Their hopes and dreams were shattered, no? So that first point, and how often does that happen to us, no? That we have our own hopes and dreams, no? And sometimes there are setbacks in our life that when we feel that everything is lost, no? Or it's a major setback that really leaves us despondent and in this case, no? Leaves them distressed, no? And downcast, no? And then the recognition happens, no? And not right away, but here the Lord introduces a very important grace of our faith, the grace of remembering. And Christ shows the process of remembering. And then the Lord says, oh, how foolish you are, no? How slow to understand, no? And then he begins, he said, as the gospel tells us, and beginning with Moses, the entire story about the Savior, beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he talked about what was written about the Messiah, no? So the grace of remembering, no? And here I think there's a very important element of remembering here. And this is what we use in our formation programs for the public school teachers, no? The remembering of the story, the narrative, no? And I think now more than ever, no? Hopefully we can reflect on this some other time during this Easter season. The narrative, the story is very important, no? In fact, in my experience of formation, to help a person heal and become whole, he or she must get in touch with her story, his narrative. Because it is in our narrative, that yung kwento ng ating buhay, it is in our stories that we discover our wholeness and discover the presence and the movement of God. And so Christ does that here. No? He gives us that framework. Remember the story. Remember everything that was written about me. And then they begin to feel something. As they say later on, were not our hearts burning as he was recounting to us the scripture, no? So finally, they were, as we say in Filipino, meron na silang kutob. And so they invite him to join them for dinner, no? Stay with us, Lord. It is nearly evening and the day is almost over. Stay with us. Wala pang Lord, no? I think they didn't say Lord, sorry, no? Stay with us. The day is almost over, no? And also he stays. And the moment of recognition is the breaking of bread. And again, remember what we said yesterday, no? That the recognition happens when the disciples encounter something familiar. Yesterday, the Lord calling out Mary by name. Today, it is the breaking of bread. Remember I said yesterday, how many times that did they share a meal, the breaking bread together? The Last Supper was breaking bread. So there they recognize him. And then they say that beautiful line, were not our hearts burning within us, no, as we were listening to him. And then here you realize this is the entire grace of the resurrection. That as the Lord helps us reinterpret the story of our lives, it's to re-inspire us also, no, to heal us of our brokenness and sinfulness. And then the breaking of bread again is the Eucharist, no? That's why the Eucharist is such a great gift, no, to us in the day-to-day to live out our mission, to take part in the mission to proclaim the good news. Remember what I said yesterday. We are living in the time of the Spirit of the risen Lord. That is what we need to proclaim, that Christ is risen. And so now the two disciples run back to Jerusalem to proclaim that, no, that Christ is risen and they become part again of the missionary church. Napakaganda nitong ebanghelyo natin ngayong araw, no? Ako talagang hinihiling ko na talagang pagdasalan natin 'to ngayong araw. Kasi narito ang mga elemento ng isang spiritual na paghubog sa atin, spiritual formation, ano? Pagsisimula ito sa hindi nila kilala ang Panginoon, ano, yung dalawang disipulo. Kasi nga lugmok sila sa kalungkutan, nagluluksa sila, pakiramdam nila natalo sila, nasayang yung tatlong taon. So hindi nila nakilala ang Panginoon, ano? Yung pangalawang punto ay sinabayan sila ng Panginoon at binigyan tayo ng isang napakagandang biyaya ng Panginoon. Yung biyaya ng pag-alaala, paggunita. Diba lagi natin sinasabi na bahagi ng ating pananampalataya, kung ano yung ating ginugunita at inaalala, pinapanatili nating buhay yung biyayang yun. Diba ang Santa Misa ay isang panalangin ng paggunita. Gawin nito bilang pag-alaala sa akin, no? Kaya ito binigay ng Panginoon, di ba? At hindi lamang yung pag-alaala, pero sinabi niya, alalahanin ang kwento, ang kabuuan ng kwento. Kaya mula kay Moises hanggang sa mga propeta, lahat ng mga propeta, pinag-usapan niya, muli niyang binanggit sa kanila at binigyan ng liwanag. Ano? Ito yung biyaya ng muling pagkabuhay ng Panginoon. Nagkakaroon ng liwanag ang ating mga karanasan. At yun ang ginawa niya ngayon. Ano? Pag-alaala at pagbibigay liwanag, ano? Ayon sa liwanag ng Panginoon na muling nabuhay. Pamamagitan ng pag-alaala ng kwento. Kasi nasa kwento ang kabuuan ng ating pagkatao, ang kabuuan ng ating paghilom, at kabuuan ng paggalaw ng Diyos sa ating buhay. Kaya nga, di ba, sabi ng sa Ebanghelyo, noong pa lamang kinukwento ng Panginoon yung kwento tungkol sa kanya, nararamdaman na nila yung ano, di ba, yung apoy, yung bugso sa kanilang puso, ano, meron na silang pakiramdam, may kutob na, no. Tapos inayahan nila, at yung pangatlong punto ay nakilala nila sa paghahati ng tinapay, ang banal na Eukaristiya. At mula dito, ano-ano naman, balik na naman yung sigla at yung inspirasyon, naging bahagi ng misyon ng simbahan, ng komunidad nila, na ang Panginoon ay tunay na buhay, na nabuhay. So today, let us reflect on this beautiful gospel. It is our journey. It is our journey from brokenness and despair to a renewed sense of hope and a renewed sense of understanding the narrative of the cross and resurrection in our own stories and narratives, and recognizing Christ at the breaking of bread, to be inspired again to be part of the mission to proclaim that Christ is risen. Recalling how the disciples on the road to Emmaus recognized Jesus in the breaking of bread, we pray to God the Father for a deeper appreciation of the risen Christ as our spiritual food for the journey through life.
That the Pope and the bishops may effectively proclaim the message of hope by their holy lives, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That government leaders may bring hope and light to our people by their dedication to public service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may understand why Christ had to suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us remember all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. And we continue to pray for the good health of the Holy Father, Pope Francis. We pray for all his intentions. And we pray especially for his intentions for peace. And we pray for the coming Synod on Synodality. For all this we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, we pray, O Lord, the sacrifice which has redeemed the human race, and be pleased to accomplish in us salvation of mind and body through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world, by dying has destroyed our death, and by rising restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Accept, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace, the unity, and the joy of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. An act of spiritual communion. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And let us pray. We pray, O Lord, that the reverent reception of the sacrament of your Son may cleanse us from our old ways and transform us into a new creation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.
Marami pong salamat. Thank you for joining us. And again, let's continue to pray and reflect during this Easter season. Thank you po.
I can't feed 5,000, but I can feed one. I can't walk in water, but I can walk in the shoes of another. I can't turn water into wine, but I can turn a frown into a smile. Sharing what I have in my hands is the miracle that needs to be seen today. Every blessing I receive is a miracle that I can share. This is what I can share. This is my Alay Kapwa.
Alay Kapwa, a flagship program of Caritas Philippines by the Catholic Bishops' Conference of the Philippines.